Over the first few decades of the 20th century, fingerprint identification became an important tool of policing and forensics in countries throughout the world. At the same time as this was happening, the friction-rich skin of the fingers and palm were also becoming a focus of scientific research. Some studied the basic anatomy of friction-rich skin, as shown here. Others studied various other aspects of friction-rich skin patterning, including its evolution in humans, its embryology, and even its genetic inheritance. This scientific interest in fingerprints grew out of other disciplines. Early on, for example, researchers with an interest in fingerprints were influenced by physical anthropology and even attempted to survey the fingerprint patterning of different racially defined populations. Over time, other scientific disciplines influenced this research as well, including genetics and medicine. In order to create a single coherent discipline for this research, which was spread out over multiple fields of science, in the mid-1920s, Tulane University anatomists Harold Cummins and Charles Midlow created the term dermatoglyphics, which is used to refer to the scientific study of ridged skin on fingers, palms, and soles. Throughout the 20th century, hundreds of researchers in different academic disciplines have carried out research in dermatoglyphics. There have even been scholarly associations, for example, the International Dermatoglyphics Association and the American Dermatoglyphics Association, which were dedicated to promoting scientific research in this field. To give one example of the kind of work that was carried out in dermatoglyphics, we might briefly examine how these methods were used in the diagnosis of congenital disorders and other health-related conditions. For decades, it had been recognized that individuals who were affected by Down syndrome, a congenital condition that is caused by the presence of an extra copy of the 21st chromosome, were likely to have certain fingerprint and palm patterns that were rarely found in unaffected individuals. These included, for example, an unexpected number of loop patterns on the fingerprints, and a triradius located close to the center of the palm, which is a different location from where this anatomical landmark is usually found. The image that you are looking at is a diagram from the 1970s, showing these and other characteristic features associated with this condition. In the post-World War II period, and especially during the 1950s and 1960s, medical research in dermatoglyphics really took off. The fact that specific friction ridge patterns were found to be associated with Down syndrome gave rise to the hope that other kinds of patterning might reveal the presence of other conditions as well. Soon researchers were trying to establish correlations between these patterns and numerous other health conditions, ranging from congenital heart disease to schizophrenia to other chromosomal disorders, such as the chromosome 18 deletions shown here. In fact, despite all of this research, the mid to late 20th century should be viewed as an important turning point in the history of dermatoglyphics, in the sense that from this point onward, there was a general decline in interest in this field. The last several decades of the 20th century were, of course, a watershed moment in understandings of human genetics, one that saw the rise of genomics and its varied medical, forensic, and other applications. While dermatoglyphics did provide techniques and insights that were valued by earlier generations of researchers and even in medical practice, as we have seen, in the end, the science of fingerprints and palms ultimately lost its authority and was superseded by other, more effective modes of scientific inquiry based on the study of DNA.